succession. Oh, maybe it sounds a bit grand. What does it mean? It means having seeds and plants ready to keep your ground as full as possible. Like here, I've got a lot of beautiful beds, lovely soil, just waiting to grow. And a lot of them are growing something already. This is actually mid-April, so the season's only just getting underway. And looking ahead, there's so many possibilities. A lot of what's in the ground here now will finish before the middle of summer. And well, then I need to have some plants ready, and I'm going to show you some options in this video. So your succession options will depend somewhat where you are, your climate, what you want to grow as well. And I must say that with no-dig, it's a lot easier because you don't have to follow the usual rules of rotation. My method is pretty much have the plants ready and then find a space. So I'm going to give you some ideas along those lines now. There's a nice contrast here between a fast cropper and a slow cropper, and how it's good to know which is which and roughly the timing. So the radish went in sown early February, transplanted late February. They're cropping now, and it won't be long before they finish. So by the end of April, this will be clear. Options then could be to sow beetroot, plant beetroot, sow carrots, plant potatoes, plant courgettes. Many options because of that time of year. There's most of the season ahead. Whereas with broad beans, they crop for longer. So even though they were sown late autumn last year, and that's why they're well ahead for this time of year, which is mid-April there, they still won't be cropping until mainly in June, first half of June. And I found over the years that a very nice sequel to broad beans, a succession, is broccoli, purple sprouting broccoli, which survives through the winter and crops the following spring. Let's look now at a vegetable which has cropped for even longer than the broad beans. Leeks are a bit more tricky because there's a whole range of possible options according to the variety which you sowed. And do check out my No Dig book for that, because we've got charts in that book which list the harvest times for a whole range of different vegetables and different types within those vegetables. Like, these are the latest kind of leek you can grow. It's a variety called Bandit, and it's designed to put on a real spurt of growth right at the end. So looking at these in like before Christmas, they were pretty small, and it's like, well, that's not going to do much. Whereas now they're just looking fantastic. There's a lot here, but they're going to flower though towards early May. So you've got to be careful not to go too long. You can't wait forever to take your harvest. And that flowering issue applies to another vegetable over here, in fact. This is true spinach, and it always flowers towards the end of May or by early June, whenever you sow it. So you can't get away from that. And I've actually got some here which I did sow this spring, and it's struggled to grow much because we've had such terrible weather this spring. And that means even though the plants are really small now, they're just not going to have much time to make leaves. And that's where actually, but knowing the flowering time, which is again where the book is very specific, it's got it all in one place. You've got all those finishing times, which you need to know almost as much as the starting times. And a good starting time for spinach in most mid-latitude climates is August. So this was sown around 10th August here. That works really well. Transplanted right at the end of the month, which means that can follow a lot of summer crops that are finishing at that time, like say dwarf French beans. And it's been in the ground all that time, cropping through the autumn a bit, through the winter even a bit, and now quite a lot. And it's going to flower towards the end of May. So options for following that could be climbing beans or any kind of summer bean or Brussels sprouts, lettuce, many options. And let's have a look at how one might go about starting them off. There comes a point when your garden is pretty well fully planted. Ah, you can relax then. No more need to do sowing and planting, but actually that's the moment you can carry on, because there's always going to be something finishing. And this propagating area has already seen 2,000 or 3,000 plants go out this year, and the garden, my homemaker's garden, is more than two-thirds planted up. But that's it's never finished, and that just goes on through the year, continually cycling and recycling. Like these, for instance, are trays that we sowed with leeks just yesterday, and they will go out probably not until late June, early July. So they will be following something like potatoes, perhaps, that finish at that time of year. But it means that I'll have the leeks partly grown already, whereas if you wait until you'll say your potatoes finish and then you sow your leeks, that's going to take a long time. You probably won't get much harvest. So the propagation part is getting ahead, having plants ready, plants more than seeds, that you increase your cropping period every year by doing that. And sometimes you don't even need to wait for the previous plant to finish before you can sow and plant again. One of the most beautiful vegetables in terms of succession is garlic, because its upright growth habit means that there's space. If you space it like we've done here in rows, say across a bed, that's easy access to, you could draw a line like this, just make a small furrow in the ground, and then you could sow carrots in there, for example. Or you could transplant also beetroot. So garlic, you don't have to wait for it to finish. It will finish around the time of solstice, normally for soft-neck garlic, a little bit later for hard-neck garlic. And I wouldn't sow or plant just yet, because all being well, it has quite a bit of growing still to do. And in fact, doing that, I notice I'm disturbing a lot of garlic roots. In other words, it's really using all this soil for its own growth. And at the moment, we don't want the other vegetable kind of getting in the way. But as we come into June, the garlic is starting to ripen and mature. It's not using the soil so much for its own vigorous growth anymore. And so that's a good time, say late May, to sow carrots, or early June to transplant beetroot is more options. I hope you've enjoyed having a look at all these possibilities for succession.